Wisdom, the final frontier to true knowledge. Welcome to Wisdom Trek, where our mission is to create a legacy of wisdom, to seek out discernment and insights, to boldly grow where few have chosen to grow before. Hello, my friend. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, your captain on our journey to increase wisdom and create a living legacy. Thank you for joining us today as we explore wisdom on our second millennium of podcast. This is day 1508 of our trek, and our focus on Friday is future technologies and societal advances. So we call it Futuristic Fridays. My personality is one that I've always been very future-oriented. Since my childhood, I have yearned for the exploration and discovery of new technologies and advancements for the future. I did grow up on the original Star Trek series, and even today, as I'm on my 65th revolution around the sun, I still dream of traveling into space. Each week, we will explore rapidly converging technologies and advancements that will radically change our lives. At times, the topics may sound like something out of a science fiction novel, but each area that we will explore is already well on its way on becoming a reality over the next couple of decades. To keep with our theme of Ask Gramps, I will put our weekly topics in a form of a question to get us on track. This week's question is, "Hey Gramps, you explained how to craft a futuristic mindset last week. One of the mindsets that you mentioned was abundance. Can you go into more detail on how to craft a futuristic abundance mindset?" So today, of course, our topic is a futuristic abundance mindset. Last week, we did learn how to craft futuristic mindset in several areas. This week, we will drill down on one aspect, which is the futuristic abundance mindset. I am using some of the information mentioned in Peter Diamandis' blog and his book, The Future is Faster Than You Think. Do you have an abundance mindset? What is an abundance mindset? What's the advantage of having an abundance mindset? And that'll be our conversation for today and next week. In the middle of a pandemic, it's hard to think about abundance. You can understand this, especially when people are losing their jobs or wondering if or when they'll ever get access to a vaccine. Nevertheless, the world is heading rapidly toward abundance, and understanding this can transform your life and your business if you have one. Exponential technology like computation, artificial intelligence, 3D printing, robotics, and virtual reality are rapidly dematerializing, demonetizing, and democratizing products and services. What used to be available only to the wealthiest and most elite is now available to almost anyone on the planet. A child in the middle of Zimbabwe can Google any information or video conference for free with someone on the other side of the world. Many things that people paid millions of dollars for just two decades ago are now available for free on your smartphone. The challenge is that our minds are probably shaped by a mindset of scarcity, and most people are trapped in an unhealthy scarcity mindset. In a world of scarcity, there is a limited pie. If your neighbor gets a slice, that means you get a smaller slice. It's a world of limited resources and fierce competition. With an abundance mindset, rather than slicing the pie into thinner and thinner pieces, we just bake more pies, millions of more pies. Abundance is the future that exponential technology enables. Abundance is growing across almost every sector of society and economy throughout the entire world, whether people see it or recognize it yet. Think about this statement and allow this to permeate your mind. Creating a world of abundance isn't about creating a world of luxury. It's about creating a world of possibility. Next week, I will focus on what I call the proof of abundance and show you the data on how we are driving abundance in almost every sector relevant to humans. It can be hard to believe, given the innate scarcity-focused neural wiring of our minds, but the data just doesn't lie. In last week's Futuristic Friday episode, I mentioned the abundance mindset is one of six crucial mindsets for a leader and an entrepreneur to develop and firmly command actively. You must ask yourself, why should you desire and develop abundance mindset? I have six components today which make up an abundance mindset. The first one is, you understand that the world is becoming more abundant, allowing you to maintain a hopeful and compelling vision of the future. I will provide supporting data and evidence in next week's episode with this. This positive mindset sets you apart from others and attracts the best team into your life and mission. Number two, you don't resent missed opportunities because you understand that you live in the world of ever-increasing opportunities. The future holds many more exciting, fulfilling, and profitable opportunities for you to pursue. The third one is, you don't have to fear the future. Instead, you can embrace it and are excited to learn all that you can to create a future for you and any businesses that you may desire. Number four, you view competitors as potential collaborators in the world of ever-increasing business opportunities. Why worry unnecessarily about your competitors when you can create another larger pie? You focus your time, attention, and resources on pursuing moonshots that are 10 times or 1,000% versus fighting in trenches for 10% improvements. Number five, you are reinventing yourself and your business through digital lenses. You must continuously dematerialize, demonetize, and democratize your life, your products, and services, making them available to a larger and larger customer base at lower and lower cost. And number six, as a leader, you convey a hopeful and compelling future that inspires and guides your associates and clients. People inherently want good news, data-driven optimism, rather than a continuous dribble of negative, crisis-oriented, amygdala-energizing banter that you find on most social media and news services. So as we finish up today, let me ask you a couple additional questions. Would your life change if you had an abundance mindset? What would crafting and mastering an abundance mindset mean to your life and your business? We will review this more next week when I review some shocking proof of abundance, what I call a refreshing breath of data-driven optimism. And as a Christ follower, we are encouraged to live abundantly. We should live abundantly because God's resources are our own. Here are a couple verses that will help you to have that mindset. The first one is John chapter 10, verse 10. The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. And in 2 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. By His divine power, God has given us everything we need to live a godly life. We have received all of this by coming to know Him, the one who called us unto Himself by means of His marvelous glory and excellence. And because of His glory and excellence, He has given us great and precious promises. These are the promises that enable you to share in His divine nature and escape the world's corruption caused by human desires. And that's a wrap for today's question. Join us again next Futuristic Friday as we look at another exciting exponential technology area, specifically why we should have an abundance mindset. And this will be part of next week's Ask Gramps episode. Our next trek will be Meditation Monday, where we will help you to reflect on what is most important in life. So encourage your friends and family to join us and to come along with us on Monday for another day of Wisdom Trek, Creating a Legacy. If you'd like to listen to any of the past 1,507 daily treks or read the associated journals, they are all available at wisdom-trek.com. And I encourage you to subscribe to Wisdom Trek on your favorite podcast player so that each day will be downloaded to you automatically. And thank you so much for allowing me to be your guide, your mentor, but most importantly, I am your friend as I serve you through the Wisdom Trek Podcaster and Journal each day. And as we take this trek of life together, let us always live abundantly, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and leave a living legacy each day. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, reminding you to keep moving forward, enjoy your journey, and create a great day every day. See you on Monday.